my name is Yusuf, and I'm a strong supporter of Israel.
You're a strong supporter of Israel?
Exactly.
Oh, really? Go ahead, Yusuf. I'm intrigued.
I believe, George, you are part of the problem why there is not going to be any peace at all in Israel. Yeah. Yes.
Tell me why, Yusuf. I'm part of the problem, my goodness.
Yeah,
who
because,
knew?
I think that propaganda is not going to lead us anywhere. We must speak the truth, George. And, yeah, I believe...
Yusuf?
Yes, I believe propaganda is not going to lead us anywhere, and we have to speak the truth when it comes to Israel. And
let's speak the truth then. Go ahead. Speak your truth.
Every particular answer has to correspond either to the empirical form of measurement or to logical reasoning process. And the naked truth about who actually is occupying whose land and has to cohere and not incohere with history, archaeology, theology, and logics. And you know from the historical point of view that land belongs to Israel. From theological point of view, it belongs to Israel. From archaeological point of view, it belongs to Israel. And now, the very fact that once a debate has been established on false, that debate is already lost and won. There is no such thing called Palestine. You know it, you smile in it. You know these are invented peoples, they never belong to that land. And from the theological point of view, they are Muslims, they are not atheists. When they claim that is their land, that means they don't even believe in Allah.
Well, it's interesting that you bring up Allah,
because
you know
Muslims.
That the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, ascended to the heavens from Palestine, from Jerusalem, from the Al-Aqsa. Now, this makes the matter of sacred importance to the Muslim Ummah, which is, as you probably know, Yusuf, almost 2 billion strong. And that mosque of Al-Aqsa is now in the hands of foreigners. You have the nerve to talk about indigenous people. But the vast majority of the citizens of Israel are not indigenous to anywhere except North America and Europe. And the people who run the state now and have always run the state are indigenous to Europe and to Europe and North America. They have nothing to do with Palestine. And
Yusuf, I'm
talking now. You spoke for quite a long time, and I'll let you back in when I'm finished talking. The people who founded this state were more than ready to found it in any number of other places other than Palestine. So your claim that God was the estate agent in all of this is absurd, because the Zionist movement first asked the British if they could create a state of Israel in the Seychelles or in Uganda or in Patagonia, in Latin America, in Argentina, what is now the state of Argentina. So there's nothing holy or religious about the claim to set up a state of Israel. It was just another European settler state, and it was ready to establish itself wherever the British Empire would give it land to do so. Secondly, as you mentioned, atheism, every single one of the Zionist leaders who wanted from Britain land to create a state of Israel was in fact an atheist. They did not believe in God, and therefore could not possibly have been claiming that God promised them the land of Palestine. But, and here's my point, because I don't really hold with going back thousands of years or relying on religious scriptures, especially those that were written by men. I ask you this, Yusuf.
Yes.
If it's as clear-cut as you say it is, then Israel has no problem now. Netanyahu has no problem. There is no threat to Israel, because according to you, from every single standpoint and by the use of any yardstick, Israel is entitled to this land.
Yes,
but they do have a problem, don't they?
Mm-hmm.
What is it? Is it me? Am I the problem?
No, let me talk. You've been talking. It looks like you are the only one who has a point. What I mean by that, you know, when we willfully and purposely deny all these facts, there'll be no solution. The only solution is we have to go back to history to know where we are and where we are from and where we are and where we are heading to. Historically, we are giving possession to the people who has no historical connection to that land. These people are Arabs. They are the land of Israel belongs to the Jews, not to the Arabs. And even before
Yusuf, let me interrupt you for a second. I'll let you continue because I'm fascinated by how you reach this standpoint, shall I say.
Yeah.
What do you mean they are Arabs? Does that mean that they are not Palestinians? Is that your point?
They are Palestinians. When we say Palestinian, this is a different thing. And the only way we can know who are Palestinians, we have to go back to history. Palestinians are a different people. We know in 585 BCE they are...
We don't have enough time to bog ourselves down in 585 BC.
Yeah,
let's try instead, Yusuf, let's try instead 2014 AD. Well, there are 13 million Palestinians, millions of them under occupation. Look, listen to me, and then I'll let you back in. There are 13 million Palestinians, millions of them under occupation and siege, but most of them outside of the land living as refugees. That is a fact. It's a clear and present threat to the existence of what they call Israel. Otherwise, Israel would have no problems and we wouldn't be having this conversation. So these real, live, 13 million Palestinians either live in Palestine or are demanding the right to return to Palestine. What are you going to do about it, Yusuf?
No, I ask you this simple question. Why are they not speaking Arabic if they are Palestinians? Because I know Palestinians are different people, like when we say Chinese. So why are they speaking Arabic now? When they are Palestinians, why are they not speaking Palestinian language?
There is no Palestinian language. The Palestinian language
is...
The Palestinian language is Arabic.
No, George,
but Yusuf,
you
get your nose out of your ancient books. I'm talking to you, not about 565 BC, but about 2014 AD. What are you going to do about the millions of Palestinian Arabs who speak Arabic, who are Christian and Muslim? What are you going to do about them?
Excuse me, George. Michael,
I think that's the heavens crying, Yusuf. Nobody can take much more of your obscurantism. Attend to your baby, please, because there are many crying children in Palestine, some of whom were killed just yesterday as Netanyahu's rage at the unity agreement reached between Hamas and Fatah was played out in the media. Israel immediately launched its airstrikes, which killed and maimed many, most of them children, in the northern part of Gaza.